And please, always, khatra is very important, so listen attentively. Inshallah, Mufti Wasim, please.
Assalamu alaikum. Just a reminder as well, we have our annual conference in a few days, inshallah. In 3 days? 3 days countdown? 4 days. I'm too excited. 4 days. If you haven't registered, please do register. Please do share the flyer, share it. We have our current imam scholars, local scholars, and a visit from Imam Yasin as well will be the keynote and a big part of the conference. So we do hope that as many people that can attend the conference can attend it, inshallah, bi'idhnillah. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihi al-kareem, amma ba'd. Babul 'uzlati rahatan min khulati as-su'. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaks about that in the time when things start getting bad and there are fitnas around, how should we behave? Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu says, جَاءَ إِعْرَابِي إِلَى النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَقَالْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَيُّ النَّاسِ خَيْرٍ. A villager, a Bedouin, comes to the Prophet and says, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَيُّ النَّاسِ خَيْرٍ. Who out of the people is the best of people? The Prophet ﷺ says, رَجُولٌ جَاهَدَ بِنَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ. A man who does jihad with his wealth and by himself. وَرَجُلٌ فِي شِعْبٍ مِنَ الشِّعَابِ يَعْبُدُ رَبَّهُ. And a person who avoids the rest of the community and the public, they go in a secluded area and they are in some outskirt and they are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَدَعُ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّهِ. And he prevents and avoids the evil of other people and inflicting his evil on other people. Sometimes we have to make a check and see and realize that the environment I am in, is it conducive for my growth, for my family growth? And I don't mean financially. Because Nabi alayhi salam talks about a time or an era that will come where the preservation of faith will be difficult. In the following hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam actually says, يَأْتِي عَلَى النَّاسِ زَمَانِ. A time will come when wealth basically will be everywhere. We live in this era. So what is the best wealth? Is it Bitcoin? Is it stocks? Is it some investment? What is the best wealth? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, خير مال الرجل المسلم الغنم يتبع بها شعف الرجال ومواقع القطر يفر بدينه من الفتن.
The best wealth a believer can have, and it's interesting that he says this, right? Because actually in Texas, many of you can actually follow through with this hadith, especially in Dallas. He says that the best wealth is to have a goat and a person who lives in the outskirts. They are running يفر من دينه. They're running for their deen and preservation of their deen. And they've stayed away. Now, why is he talking about having a goat? Every person around the Prophet at that time had goats. So imagine if the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam giving this advice 1400 years ago. It's like me saying, the best, a time will come when the best thing that you can have is a car. And you're all like, we all have cars. Why is this so strange? But when you think about it now, does anybody have a goat here? Okay, even back home. Does anyone have a goat back home? We'll count back home too. Get a goat somewhere. But the reality is, fitna will envelop and engross us. Okay, now why does this happen? When does Allah release His doors of fitnas upon the ummah? The Prophet ﷺ says that, إِذَا ضُيِّعَتِ الْأَمَانَةِ فَانْتَظِرِ السَّاعَةِ. When trust and amana is gone, then wait for the day of judgment. فَقِيلَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. The Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, كَيْفَ إِضَاعَتُهَا. How is amana and trust going to disappear? فَقَالَ إِذَا وُسِّدَتِ الْأَمَرُ إِلَى غَيْرِ أَهْلِهَا. When people who are not fit for the responsibility are executing the responsibility. That the amana that's given to them, when they betray, and it comes from us leadership. It comes from the top. It comes, everyone is some sort of a leader. Whether it's in their sector, in their community, in their home, in their friend groups. Everyone is a certain level, has a certain influence. And the Prophet ﷺ says, إِذَا ضُيِّعَتِ الْأَمَانَةِ When trust disappears, فَانْتَظِرِ السَّعَةِ, know that the day of judgment. People give their word and they go back. And the next hadith is a long hadith where the Prophet describes the process of how it eliminates. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, so there's a hadith of Sayyidina Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu. Hudhayfa bin Yaman is known as Sahibu Sirr al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahabi who held the secrets of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He knew of all the munafiqeen's name, and he held this huge, you know, some people like certain things, right? Someone likes Islamic finance, someone likes, you know, all about telling about jinn, someone likes Day of Judgment, everyone's got their وَلِلنَّاسِ فِي مَا يَحْشَقُونَ مَذَاهِبُ. Mutanabbi says everyone has their path, their likening, and we service those things. So Hudhayfa bin Yaman liked this, and he said that the Prophet ﷺ told me two things. One, I have seen with my eyes, and the other I'm still waiting for. He says, أَنَّ الْأَمَانَةَ نَزَلَتْ فِي جَذْرِ قُلُوبِ الرِّجَالِ, that Allah had taken amana, trust, honesty, integrity, and He had ingrained it into the heart of men and women. Then he said, ثُمَّ عَلِمُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ, it was existent in humanity, and when the Qur'an came and people learned the Qur'an and acted on it, that amana increased, and that trust increased. ثُمَّ عَلِمُوا مِنَ السُّنَّةِ, then they learned the hadith in the prophetic way, and their trust increased even more, and their honesty and integrity was preserved. Then he says, وَحَدَّثْنَا, he said, this I have seen, because he lived amongst the Sahaba, the honest people I have seen. Then he says, then he told us, عَنْ رَفْعِهَا, how will this disappear? How will society begin to decline? There is a book by Mawlana Abul Hasan Ali al-Nadwi. If you don't read any book in your life, and you're a parent, and you want to inspire Islam in your children, just read this one book. It's called Islam and the World. You can download the PDF online, Islam and the World. The actual book is in Arabic. The name of the book is مَاذَا خَسِرَ الْعَالَمْ بِإِنْحِطَاطِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, what has humanity lost when the Muslims began to decline? And Sayyid Qutb has this introduction. I swear, even if you just read the introduction, you will understand the state we are living in, and you will be able to help and inspire your children to love their deen. Anyway, so he says that this amana will be raised. يَنَامُ الرَّجُلُ النَّوْمَ فَتُقْبَضُ الْأَمَانَ مِنْ قَلْبِهِ, people will begin to sleep, and slowly amana, Allah will take out of their heart, because they are being dishonest. A little cheating here, a little cheating there. ثُمَّ يَنَامُ النَّوْمَ فَيَظَلُّ أَثَرُهُ مِنْ أَثَرِ الْكُوَكِثِ, he says, the example of that trust remaining in their heart is like someone wants to take fire and brand it. You know when you have a little effect of fire burnt? He says, like that brand, that scar. It's like a scar on them. It existed once upon a time. Then a little while later, the person will go to sleep, and then Allah will remove the remaining effect of it, and it will remain like a blister, and it will only be pus and filth that will be remained inside them. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that a time will come, وَلَيْسَ فِيهِ فَيُصْبِحُ النَّاسِ يَتَبَايَعُونَ فَلَا يَكَادُ أَحَدٌ يُؤَدِّ الْأَمَانَةِ, a time will come when people will not find anyone who they can do business with and they can trust. And a person will look from door to door finding, who can I trust? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَيُقَالُ لِلْرَجُلِ مَا أَعْقَلَهُ وَمَا أَذْرَفَهُ وَمَا أَجْلَدَهُ وَمَا فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالُ حَبَّةِ قَرْدَلٍ مِنْ إِيمَانٍ, people will say, so-and-so person, they're trustworthy, honest, trust that person. They look like a person with integrity. And the Prophet said, they won't even have a speck of faith in their heart. People will think they're honest and dignified, they have no faith in their heart. And then the Prophet ﷺ says, وَلَقَدْ, and then he says, وَمَا, okay. Hudhayfa bin Yaman then says, وَلَقَدْ أَتَى عَلَيَّ زَمَانٍ, he said, a time came when I used to do business, and if there was a Muslim I did business with, I said his Islam will protect him, and if I did business with a Christian, I would say his Christianity would protect him, and they would be honest. He said, now, and he's in the Tabi'in time, I don't do business besides with few people. And I just want to take the last few minutes on this point. How many, I mean, it's in our own community, we've seen these stories. When masjids get expanded and these things, what do people say? Don't take a Muslim contractor. Brother Manzoor knows this stuff too well. No comment.
We've seen this in our own homes. We've seen this when we do businesses. You know, you see another Muslim, you know what our mentality is? How do I not grow somebody else? You know, in Islamic Spain, there was, if you've ever been to any tourist location, you have a bunch of people that sell their local commodity, right? Maybe a souvenir or something. You see in Pakistan, Turkey. The first person is always the most expensive. And then when you go down the route, everyone's selling the same thing. But down there is cheaper. You know what I'm talking about or no? Yes? You know, okay. I was in Beijing once and I went to Tiananmen Square. First person said, hand woven purse for your mother, for this, for that. I said, amazing. How much? They said, $350. I said, this is a steal. It's like $5, $10. By the time I got to the end, the same thing was being sold for $50. So like this person had a bunch of stores. So a tourist comes and he goes to buy something. And he says, my brother, don't go down there, a few stores. You'll find a person right there. He sells the exact thing I sell for the same price I sell. Go get it from him. So the man said, I'm giving you business. You're sending me elsewhere. You're a bad businessman. He said, no. He also has a family, and I also have a family. I got my business for today, and I was noticing he didn't get many sales. But if you go, you'll be able to take care of it. This is big in the Ismaili community. One of my friends in Houston was telling me a story. He said he went to a car dealership. You know, sometimes they have the same last name, Patels, right? Patels are Patels everywhere. So he says that he went to a car dealership. When he arrived there, he realized it was the wrong person. So he says, I'm sorry, I'm at the wrong dealership. He's like, where is yours? He's like, don't worry about it. That man's from our community. You give him business. Adinun nasiha. Deen, the whole Islam is only one thing. Wanting to see everyone excel. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah's treasure is infinite. He can give you, me, and everyone else, and nothing drops. Want good for everyone. Hope to see everyone exceed, excel, and be happy for people's happiness. That is what a believer is. Jazakallah khair. This is my last khatira. Next week, I will be in Umrah. So please forgive me for anything I've said or done, especially Brother Manzoor, if how much I've bothered him. But please forgive me for anything I have said or done. Of course, the community will be in our du'as. And inshallah, when I return, we will resume. But this conference that's happening this weekend, again, we've delayed our Umrah trip for this conference. This is a very important conference for our community. A lot of time and effort is put into it. And we really hope we take this as if this is we are the hosts of this conference. The people who are the daily musallis, you are the hosts of this conference. So please take it to your heart, take it to your family. There are sessions for seniors, youth, young professionals, sisters, counselors, everything. Please do come as much as you can. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.